What's going on, guys? This video is going to be an in-depth tutorial on how to use TradingView, so let's get started. The website is www.tradingview.com. Once you're on the website, create a free account. TradingView is a great charting platform, and I use this to plan out some of my trades. So something to keep in mind, the price data on the US stocks are from CBOEBZX exchange, but if you are trading stocks from NASDAQ, NYSE, or NYSE Arca, then there is a 15-minute delay. However, if you already purchased a real-time data subscription from your broker, then you do not need to pay for them again in order to get access on TradingView. All you have to do is connect your broker through the trading panel. This can be found by going to the bottom of the chart and click on Trading Panel. Find the broker that you are currently using and click Connect. If you are trading Forex or cryptocurrency, then the data is automatically in real time. The real time data for Forex and cryptocurrency is free by default. The first thing that I like to do is switch to dark mode. Right click on the chart and click Color Theme. And then from here, you can choose between the light or dark mode. The first thing that we're gonna go over is how to use their charting platform. On the search bar, type any security that you want to look at. For example, let's take a look at Tesla. Now let's go over the top menu bar first. The first one here is the time frame. It's currently set to the letter D. This is the daily time frame, which means each candle represents one day of price movement. If you click on this, then you can see a list of all the different time frames. Let's say you want to look at the hourly time frame. All you have to do is just click on it and there you go. The chart that you're looking at will now be based on the 1 hour time frame. Also, if you add the time frame to your favorites by clicking on this star, that time frame will now appear on the menu bar, so you don't have to click on the drop down menu to see it. Click this candle icon if you want to change the type of chart that you want to look at. I'm currently looking at the candlestick chart, but if you want to look at a different type, for example, let's say you want to look at the line chart, just click on it and your chart type will automatically change. The next on this menu is the indicators. You can create your own indicator by using PineScript. This is TradingView's programming language that allows you to create a custom indicator. Now click on technicals. There are a few things that you can do here. First, you can look through the list of indicators that they already have, or if you already know what type of indicator you want, then all you have to do is search for it. For example, let's say you want to add the EMA to your chart. Search for EMA and click on moving average exponential, and there you go. It will automatically get added onto your chart. Now, they also made pre-made strategies, but I'm not sure how reliable these are. I've never used them. Now, you can also add volume profile, which shows you where traders are making trades and at what particular price levels. You will need to upgrade your basic account to a pro account if you want to use the volume profile. The next one is the auto, and this will show you a list of patterns that you can choose from. Whichever one you choose, it will automatically try to identify it on the current chart that you are looking at. This will let you know when that pattern is formed. For example, let's say you want to know when a double top pattern is formed. You can see here that it identified the double top pattern. Now, this will not show you where to enter and where to exit, but I have plenty of videos that will show you that, so don't worry, I got you covered. The next one on the technical indicators is the candlestick patterns. Let's say you want to be notified when a doji candle is formed. You can see here that it identifies the doji candles automatically. If you leave this on, then the next time that a doji candle forms, the doji indicator will automatically pop up in your chart. Click on financials, and here you can add things from the income statement, which shows you things like the total revenue, income, etc. For example, if we add the total revenue, this will show you the total revenue each time they released an earnings report. You can also add things from the balance sheet, cash flow, and statistics. The last one on the indicators menu is the community scripts. These are custom scripts written by other TradingView users. The next one on the top menu bar is the indicator templates. This allows you to group several studies or indicators together, and you can then apply it on any chart. For example, if we take a look at one of the default templates, let's take a look at volume based. You can see here that it automatically shows all four indicators that were saved for that template. You can create your own by adding the indicators that you want on your chart and then click Save Indicator Template. This way you don't have to keep adding it individually if you want to look at a different stock symbol. All right, so the next one that we're gonna go over on the top menu bar is the alerts. This will show you how to set up alerts based on price and volume. If you click on the drop-down menu, you can choose to set up an alert based on these conditions. For example, let's say you want to set up an alert if Tesla passes above a certain price, choose crossing up, and the next thing you want to do is input the value. Let's say you want to be notified when Tesla's price crosses above $250. Now you can pick if you only want this alert to happen once or every time the price crosses above $250. You then have to choose an expiration for this alert, pick which month, the day, and the time. If you want to keep this alert forever, then choose open-ended. After that, choose how you want to be notified, either through the mobile app, a pop-up on the TradingView platform, through your email, a webhook URL, or email to SMS. You can choose more than one. The next thing that you have to do is create a name for this alert. I'll put Tesla above $250. This way I'll know right away when I get this notification that this means Tesla's price is crossing above $250. Lastly, add a message, and this can be whatever you want to write. It can be a reminder of what you want to do next once this alert is triggered, or you can write your trading plan for this trade. Once you are done, click create, and this alert will be added onto your chart. Setting up price alerts is very important because this will save you time and you don't have to keep an eye on every chart on your watch list. You can set up price alerts based on when you are planning on entering or exiting. So this way, when those prices are reached, you will be notified. The next on the top menu bar is the replay button. This allows you to replay any moment in time on the chart. This can be used to study the past price action, trading history, or if you want to analyze a specific point in time. Once you click on replay, you then choose how far back you want to go and then click on that specific candle. Let's say you want to go back to April 4, 2022 before the price started to decline. You can see here that all the candles after April 4, 2022 disappeared. Now all you have to do is click on the play button and it will replay from that moment until today's date. You can also change the speed and the time frame. The next one on the top menu bar is the undo and redo buttons. Let's say you accidentally added something or you did something. If you click the undo, then it will undo what you just did. You can also press Ctrl Z on your keyboard to undo. The next one is this square button. This allows you to select the type of layout. For example, let's say you want to use the multiple chart layout. This will allow you to view more than one symbol or time frame at once. For example, let's say you want to view Tesla and SPY at the same time, or Tesla in a daily time frame and then a 15-minute time frame. This feature does require you to upgrade to the pro version. The next one is the search tool. This allows you to search for tools. For example, let's say you want to look for the horizontal lines. Click on it and click on where you want to place it on your chart, and there you go. Alright, the next button on the menu bar is the chart settings. This is where you can customize how you want the charts to look. You can also access the chart settings by left-clicking on your chart and click on settings. Let's start with symbol and work our way down. Here you can change the color of the candles. Mine is set to bright green and red, but you can change this color to whatever color you want. You can also add different price lines on your chart and change the color for each of those. For example, let's say you want to add the bid and ask price lines. You can see here that it added the bid and ask lines on the chart, but not the label. To add the label, right click on the price scale and go to labels and click on bid and ask labels, and there you go. Under data modification, you can choose if you want to display the pre-market and after hours or just the regular hours. You can see here that if I click on the extended trading hours, it will show the pre-market, which is color gray, and then the post-market colored in teal. You can change these colors to whatever color you want. For precision, I leave it to default. This is if you want to change how many decimals you want to see on the price scale. You can see that if I change it to 1-1, it removes the decimal on the price scale. And if I choose 1-10, it only adds one decimal point. For the time zone, I set mine to New York because I trade US stocks. The status line is this information that you see right here. You can uncheck some of these if you don't want to see it. Scales is where you can customize how you want to see things in the price scale. For example, if you want to see the symbol name, you can also add the bid and ask labels, the high and low price, the labels of the indicator that you are using, and you can also add a countdown so you can see when the next candle will start forming. I just leave the rest the way it is. For the appearance, here you can choose the background color of your chart. If you want a solid color or a gradient color, I chose the gray and black gradient. You can choose whatever color you want. The watermark is if you want to see the security symbol on your chart. You can also adjust the top, bottom, and the right margin of your chart. For trading, you can use this once you have linked your broker onto your TradingView account. You can enter and exit your positions directly from TradingView. And lastly, the events. This gives you the option to view when the dividends, splits, and earnings happened on the chart. The labels will show up on the bottom of the chart, just above where the dates are. For example, if you click on the label with the letter E, this shows you when the earnings report happened and the results of that earnings report. The letter S shows you when they split the shares. You can see here on August 25, 2022, Tesla had a 3-to-1 split. The next one on the menu bar is if you want to view the chart in full screen mode. And the camera button allows you to take a screenshot of your chart. And finally, the last button on this menu bar is the publish button. This is if you want to share your ideas with the other TradingView users. Alright, now let's move on to the menu bar on the right side. The first button is the watch list. Here you can create a watch list or add to the current list by clicking on the plus sign. You can also adjust the size of this window by dragging the edge to the left or to the right. The next button is for the alerts. This will allow you to add and edit the alerts that you created. The next button will show you the news and events based on the security symbol that you are looking at. You can see here that it's showing news related to Tesla, where the news source is coming from, along with the date and time it was published. The next button is the data window. This will show you things like the opening price, closing price, the high and low, the volume, etc. The next button is this fire icon, which is called the hot list. These are pre-built and it scans the US market to show you some potential opportunities. This is different from the watch list that you create. Here you can see the top volume gainers, and top losers based on the percentages. The next button is the economic calendar, which shows you events, news, and announcements that could affect the forex market. The next one is the light bulb icon, and this is where you can create your own analysis or tutorial and you can choose to post it privately or publicly. The next button is for the public chats. There are different chat rooms that you can participate in depending on the category or topic that you are interested in. Alright, the next one is for private chats. You can chat with a particular user or group and it will show up here. And the next button after that is called the Ideas Stream. The notifications will show up here if someone commented on your idea or followed you. You'll also get notifications about other users that you follow and the ideas that you follow. The next button is for live streams. You can become a streamer or watch others live stream about trading and educational content. Now this bell icon is for notifications when you get a new follower, comment, likes, etc. The next two buttons on this menu bar can be used if you connect your broker to TradingView. This is the order panel. I don't have mine connected, but if yours is connected, then you'll be able to place orders from here. The next one is called DOM, which stands for Depth of Market, and this shows you a list of how many open buy and sell orders there are for the different prices based on the security that you are looking at. The second last button on this menu bar is called the Object Tree, and this will show you all the items that you've added onto your chart, for example, your drawings, the indicators that you added, etc. This is where you'll be able to manage and organize everything on your chart. And finally, the last thing on this menu bar is the Help Center. Here you can find answers to the issues that you might be having when you're using the TradingView platform. Alright, now let's move on to the left menu bar. The first button that you see here is where you'll be able to switch between the crosshair, the arrow, the dot, and the eraser. I like to leave it on the crosshair, that way I can see where my mouse is pointing. If you want to move around the chart, all you have to do is press and hold the left button on your mouse and drag it to wherever you want to go on your chart. You can use your mouse scroll to zoom in and out. You can also adjust the price scale by pressing and holding down the left button on your mouse while dragging the price scale up or down. The next one is where you'll be able to find the trend lines, horizontal lines, and a few more lines depending on what you need. These lines are helpful for mapping out the support and resistance on the chart. The next one is called the GAN and Fibonacci tools, and there's a variety of them that you can choose from. Below that is the button for the geometric shapes, and this is where you can add things such as the brush, the highlighter, or if you want to draw shapes on the charts. For example, let's say you want to use the rectangle shape to show where the supply zone is. You can then change the color, the size, and the opacity using the menu bar for this shape. The next button is for the annotation tools, and here you can find tools such as the text if you want to leave notes on your charts. You can also add callouts, and you can even add arrow markers. The patterns button allows you to draw and identify the patterns very quickly. For example, if you use the head and shoulders pattern, when you click on the chart, it will show you to trace the left shoulder first, and then the head, and then lastly the right shoulder. The next button is called the prediction and measurement tools. This is useful for using price predictions or calculating the risk to reward. For example, let's say you're going long on a trade. You then drag this to where your entry, your stop loss, and where your target is, and this will automatically measure your risk to reward ratio. If you double click on this, you can then input your position size, your precise entry point, and your exit points, and it will automatically calculate your potential profit and loss. The next button on this menu bar is the icons, and here you can choose from a variety of different icons that you could add onto your chart. Next is the measurement button, and this allows you to measure the distance between the candles. The next buttons are used for zooming in and zooming out on certain parts of the chart. This magnet button allows you to quickly snap on your drawings onto the nearest key points. For example, let's say you want to draw horizontal lines to map out the support and resistance. All you have to do is go near the key level that you want to draw on, and it will automatically snap onto the nearest key level price point. The next button is called Stay on Drawing Mode. When this is activated, this will allow you to continuously use the same drawing tool without having to click on it again. For example, let's say you want to continuously use the horizontal line. All you have to do is make sure that this is on and watch what happens. I can continuously plot the horizontal lines without having to click on it again. Now, this lock button is to prevent you from accidentally moving or deleting your drawings on your chart. For example, let's say you drew a trend line and a horizontal line on your chart and you want to make sure that this doesn't move by accident. If you don't have this lock on, then you can easily move your drawings around. But once this lock is on, then you won't be able to move any of your drawings. The second last button on this menu bar allows you to choose if you want to hide your drawings, your indicators, positions, and orders. You can also choose to hide them all. And if you click on it again, then your drawings will become visible. The last button can be used if you want to delete the drawings and indicators on your chart. You can also just click on your drawings and press delete on your keyboard. The next thing that I want to show you is the stock screener. The screener can be found at the bottom of the chart. They also have a Forex screener and a crypto screener. Click here to maximize this panel. If you click on the top gainers beside the filters button, then you'll be able to see a list of the pre-built scanners that you can choose from. They have volume leaders, top gainers, top losers, all-time high, etc. Now, if you want to find even more specific stocks based on the strategy that you are using, click on filters, and here you'll be able to set up the screener based on the criteria that you're looking for. You have a lot of different options here that you can play around with. And that's it. I hope this video helped. If you have any questions or requests, just leave a comment down below. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Thank you for watching.